Broussard gave it to you. Why should they be ranked higher than second worst?
First of all, I'm not Dallas's defensive lawyer, first off. So I'm not coming to the table trying to convince people why they should be higher. That's hogwash, if you ask me. What I will tell you is factual information that I look at when I do my prep work for my show, which is my part in the show. Is that they do have the ability to be better than next to last in defense in the league. 31st, you can't go down too much further. So there's your first reason why they can be a better defense this year and should be higher than what they are. But you look at Lawrence and Gregory on the defensive front. If Randy Gregory's mind, and listen, all of these are going to be ifs, of course, because, well, we haven't seen it play out yet. So ifs and fifths, right? If DeMarcus Lawrence is healthy, he's going to be a grown man. Randy Gregory is basically the same type of player, just a tad bit maybe lighter, but maybe faster. So you're talking about really strong edge guys. When you get into Gallimore and Watkins on the inside interior of that defense, I like the size and athleticism that they bring to the table with that group. They can anchor inside. They can handle those double teams and create double teams that are going to possibly create single man blocking schemes for the outside guys. That is good, especially if you're going to bring the next level and have different guys blitzing at different times, which I do believe Quinn will do that with Parsons and Van Der Esch and Smith. They're very athletic. Could be the best linebacking core, one of them, in the National Football League before long. Just keep an eye on them. I'm just keeping it real. Then you have Trayvon, who at the cornerback's position, I think I like Diggs. And then what's even more, I think, intriguing to watch in this defense and why they will probably be a better defense is dating back to 2015, you haven't had a guy get three or more interceptions on this defense, which is crazy to think that for 2015 till now, three interceptions is all a guy could muster or less for this Dallas team. So you bring in Devontae Casey from Atlanta. Although he dealt with an Achilles injury and kind of fell off just a little bit, he still is a disruptive ball-hawking defensive player in that back end of a defense. Makes a difference and will truly give this defensive front the opportunity and the freedom to do some of the things creatively that Dan Quinn wants to do. We know that he loves building defensive backfields. Donovan Wilson is also in the back end of that defense. I'm not sure how good their safeties tandem will be. That's something to look for because Dan Quinn historically has a defensive backfield in safeties that really is a catalyst to his linebackers that really plays out with the defensive front and with the corners. So I do think that they'll be better than 31st. I think they'll take a dramatic step. To what degree, I'm not sure, but I think they do have the scheme and personnel to be able to take a dramatic step away from 31st ranked.
First of all, let me start here. And I love the athletic. It is outstanding work that they do. But our man, LaVar Arrington, sat on this show yesterday and told all of America that the Cowboys are going to be the new monsters of the Midwest.
Another reference.
And the athletic just dismissed it.
Here we go.
They not only dismissed it, they went in the opposite direction.
They definitely did.
LaVar, I got your back.
You
cannot disrespect my man like that.
I appreciate that.
I got your back. 31st? That is ridiculous. They weren't that bad last year. And I thought they were one of the worst defenses I'd ever seen last year. I mean, they weren't ranked 31st last year.
They were bad.
They were like 23rd or something like that. All right? And they're going to be worse? Dan Quinn is not going to make a difference? Micah Parsons is not going to make a difference. Trayvon Diggs, Leighton Van Der Esch on a contract year. Jalen Smith, DeMarcus Lawrence, you mentioned him, Randy Gregory, not going to make any difference. The fact that they should have a better run game. The fact that Dak will be quarterbacking rather than Andy Dalton.
That will make a difference.
The fact that they can play complementary football and those guys should help put the defense in better situations. None of that's going to make a difference. 31st? I'm sorry. Look, I'm not going as far as LaVar and saying they're going to be the Orange Crush or the Fearsome Foursome. But my goodness, 31st? Second to last, that's ridiculous. I think they can be either a middle of the pack top third in the league defense. They can get up to 12, 13, something like that. And with the offense, that's all they need to be a good team. Remember the division they're playing in, too. Taylor Heinicke and Ryan Fitzpatrick and Jalen Hurts and Danny Dimes, those dudes are going to make them the second worst defense in the league. I can't go with 31st.
I don't think they took a schedule into account. But, Chris, I will push back just a tad because I largely agree with you, gentlemen. Listen, this defense and all those guys you mentioned, they were there last year in the first 4 weeks with Dak in the offense, and they got shredded. They got torched. Now, they did face a bunch of playoff teams. The Browns made the playoffs. Seattle made the playoffs. Falcons did not sniff the playoffs, but they hung a ton of points and stats on that Dallas defense. I guess, LaVar, my problem is, what is Dan Quinn going to do with the defense? Are they going to be a pressure the quarterback unit? Because they could not last year. They ranked 19th in pressure rate last year. Here's the other problem. They could not get to the quarterback. I know you love Lawrence. He's really, really nice on the edge. But they ranked 25th in quarterback knockdowns. If you can't pressure the quarterback, you can't knock him down. By the way, the top six teams in quarterback knockdowns, they all made the playoffs. Steelers, the great teams. If you can get to the quarterback, that is one of the most important stats I look at before I make a wager, is pressure rate. Can you get to the opposing quarterback? And Dallas, frankly, cannot. And, you know, they spent their first five picks, I think, defensively. Their secondary is being completely rebuilt with a ton of young guys. LaVar, this idea that we can rely on a 22-year-old Micah Parsons to rejuvenate a defense and Dan Quinn, whose units in Atlanta were middle of the pack, I don't think it's going to be automatic. But the only reason I'm siding with you guys here just a little bit is because the schedule of quarterbacks they face is very easy. They open against Brady, and then it gets significantly easier. As Chris said, the division is very bad. I'll put the Cowboys probably in the 15 to 20 range for defense. And again, I know it sounds like I'm bashing the team. LaVar, I know you're licking your chops. This is an 11-win team in that division. When you face Jalen Hurts twice, Ryan Fitzpatrick, who's turning into a pumpkin, by the way, in week two, you face those guys twice, you're going to be all right.
A defense can go from horribly bad to really good in a matter of a season in the National Football League. In fact, I've seen it, and I've been a part of it. I had four different defensive coordinators during the course of my first 4 years in the league. And for the most part, early on, we did not have the best of defenses. A little bit later on, second, third year, we did have a pretty good defense. 1 year we had Kurt Schein. First year we had Ray Rhodes, aggressive style of play caller, and we did fairly well. Second year we had Kurt Schottenheimer, who we did really well, but we weren't an aggressive style of defense. So I don't necessarily agree that you have to get to the quarterback to have success as a defense. You got to be able to stop the run, and you got to be able to cover. That's what you really need to be able to do. Sacks come from, and pressure comes from, being able to get enough time to get to the quarterback. If a quarterback doesn't have to hold the ball long, then you're not going to have an opportunity to be able to have success in the pass rush. If you're getting rid of the ball quickly, then those should be very short plays, and you should be able to tackle, keep the offense in front of you, get off the field on third down. That's how it should play out. This unit was a step or two too slow last year against the run. Against the pass, they just were a step too slow. If you watch the film and break it down, it's just one or two steps away. And we all know in the National Football League, one or two steps is the death of a unit. So to me, I looked at the defensive scheme. Mike Nolan comes in with a defensive scheme. Everybody, you can ask anybody, people talk about how complicated his playbook is, how people have a lack of understanding as to what exactly they're being asked to do within each certain play call as it applies to each certain play called against that play call. There's a whole lot of mathematics and arithmetic in terms of trying to put together the equations that Nolan was trying to make himself seem like a defensive guru genius on calling plays. You're going to be a step or two too slow trying to do that. Dan Quinn is not going to bog these dudes down with too much terminology, too many adjustments, adaptations as the ball is being snapped or pre-snap or motions, whatever. Shift. Hey, if somebody goes into trips, shift based off of the motion. Make sure that you're maintaining. If it's 1-2, make sure you're splitting 1-2. If it's 2-3, if it's 2-3-4, make sure you're where you're supposed to be alignment-wise. Once that ball is snapped, play fast. Keep it in front of you. Don't let it get over top of you. Play fast. Be where you're supposed to be. Be in your gaps. That is how Dan Quinn coaches his defenses. That will be the main reason why this team improves. You don't have to improve an already good personnel grouping. You have to put them in positions to be able to be a good personnel group. And that's a lot of times what's missed when we look at coaches. We don't really hold coaches accountable for not being really good coaches. There are a lot of coaches that just don't coach well. But you know what? We'll look at it and we'll blame the personnel. To me, you have a good coach and you have good personnel. That equals a good, to me, that's a good equation to have a much improved defense that's rated 31st by the Athletic.
So Pro Football Focus, Chris, said the secondary was the 31st rated secondary in the NFL. So is the personnel there, LaVar? Well, I mean, Trevon Diggs is your number one corner. He got lit up like a Christmas tree as a rookie last year. It was ugly.
It wasn't bad at times. I mean, again, when you're talking about schematics, if something looks really egregiously wrong, like, all right, Trevon drops a receiver, the receiver keeps going, the safety isn't over top, who looks bad? Generally, it's the corner that looks bad, but it was probably the safety that needed to be over top of that route. There are certain little minute details that you have to look at in terms of what a defensive scheme represents. If you got guys that are crossing over, when you make your calls, are you making your calls early or are you making them late? Are they pre-snap or are they post-snap? If a guy runs an inside route, are you calling him in? Are you calling him in? What's the call? Are y'all on the same page? How are you communicating? If he runs an out or he runs a dig, who's taking that dig? Who's taking the double move that's going up the seam? Who's taking that move that goes outside and up? All of these little things that you have to have communication and know that you're on the same page and confidence in knowing what the defense scheme is and what you do in it plays a major part. And I think that there were a lot of breakdowns in communication and execution on this defense under Nolan. I do not think that those things will be present with Dan Quinn because he has a way of making it digestible for the defense to be able to understand it in a way where you can play much faster. I want to get to 1+2=2. That's all I want to do. I don't want to do the equation of 3x times this times x, y to z to pi equals this to be able to play defense. It's football, people. It's football. This is not rocket science. It's football. Put them in position to make plays, and I think that that's what Dan Quinn is going to do this season.
Yeah, look, I don't want to make Dan Quinn out to be Vince Lombardi. I've never talked about
an assistant coach so much. I wasn't even trying to be funny.
No, I wasn't even trying to be funny. I'm saying I do agree, though, in football, far more than basketball or baseball, a coach makes a huge difference. The Dallas defense was not bad before Mike Nolan got there with a lot of the same players. They were like 12th in the league, 13th in the league, 6th in the league, 5th in the league. And then Nolan gets there, and I agree, he overcomplicated things, and they fell off. And so I do think Quinn can come in and make them serviceable, at least on that side of the football.
All right.
I mean, no, I'm saying like top third, 12th, 13th, something like that.
You so one way or the other, listen, like the other part really is, serviceable it, or the monsters of the Midway, the 2000 Ravens.
There's no middle ground with Broussard.
No middle ground.
I just want to point out quickly, you guys looked at Minnesota, you were singing
like Aretha Franklin yesterday.
Minnesota had to pay Kirk Cousins, so they had to shed a bunch of defensive players. The Cowboys knew they had to pay Dak Prescott, so they were out with a bunch of guys in the last 2 years preparing for this huge payday for Dak. So there's been a lot of turnover. Ultimately, I'm optimistic about this group, not quite on LaVar's
level. Oh, here we go. Right.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.